are awfully quiet.
Look, I don't want to talk about it, all right?
Yeah, neither would I if I'd blame me only chance.
Now, it's too bad you're getting too big for your boots. Look, it's all your fault it was wrecked in the first place, so shut up, Kelly.
I just say, if you're going to do something, you might as well do it right.
I'm going to bloody well kill you!
Hey, come on, come
get off! Kelly! Get off me, fat guts! Come on, I'll take on the two of you. What's the matter? You're afraid to face me one-to-one? Some bloody top dog. You're all talk and no action.
Yes, it's Rep Keane. The women claim that Miss Ferguson has just been harassing her.
Ah, oh, what is it this time? A bashing, shoving straw up her fingernails? They've tried it all before.
Let's keep calm, please.
It's threatening to push her off the stairway out in his solitary.
When did they claim this happened?
Less than half an hour ago.
Oh, Governor, this really is too much. I've been sitting here with you for at least an hour. Now, Keane's just trying to stir up trouble.
Either you admit the incident was a fabrication or somehow explain how Miss Ferguson managed to be in two places at once. Well?
Well, I don't know. I can remember being on the stairs and then I don't know. Maybe someone else was there or...
Oh, you were lying.
The bloke that did win the microwave oven and the $3,000 probably reckons that it's easier to climb barefoot up Mount Everest than to cook beef Wellington on national television. Merv Pringle.
During the 8 weeks following the patient's nervous breakdown, she was given electroconvulsive therapy a total of 27 times. Short treatment.
I knew they used it occasionally. 27 times? I mean, it's a wonder she's still alive.
Here, this will make you feel better.
Oh, thanks.
All right?
Look, I'm sorry I caused so much trouble with Ferguson.
It's okay. My fault for jumping in.
Nora, why would the women in Blackmore hate me? Well, Mrs. Reynolds wouldn't lie to me, would she?
Well, she's always played it straight with me. Why?
She reckons that all of the women in Blackmore hate me and I can't even remember.
Well, you're in Wentworth now, and as long as you don't tread on anyone's toes, you'll soon make friends.
Oh, you reckon? Lou hates me. I don't know why, but she does.
She been getting heavy?
I've never done anything to her. I wouldn't. Why does she hate me, Nora?
Lou can be a real troublemaker. She starts hassling you, you let me know and the council will deal with it.
Lag on her? Oh, Nora, you know I can't do that.
Yeah, Alexa got me peas ready to dish up and Mr. P's not even around.
Yeah, who needs him, huh?
I wonder how he's doing in that contest. Probably be over by now, I suppose.
Oh, who cares?
Change the subject, will you?
Hey, Lex, are you still upset about them designs, are you?
What do you reckon? It'd be nice to know what they thought.
Yeah.
Hey, I know! We can make him a cake.
Oh.
Mr. P.
What for?
Well, sort of like congratulations for being in the contest.
Look, he hasn't even won yet, Daff. We're going to look pretty stupid standing around a cake singing for he's a jolly good fellow if he's lost.
No, it's the thought that counts, Lex.
I wouldn't mind, would he? Daff, I know you're born yesterday, but that's a ridiculous idea.
Hey, look, we've got time. We can make it. Bowl cakes are really easy. We'll make him a chocolate fruit cake.
So you're going to coat yourself in chocolate, are you?
And we don't even need a recipe because cakes are really...
Oh, Daffy!
No, don't worry. I saw it on the telly. They have flour in them and... Oh, eggs. I hope it gets in the eggs.
Wasn't Mr. Russell Clark marvellous?
So were you, Joyce. You had more confidence in me than I did. But you wanted me to carry on with it when I wanted to give it away.
Nonsense. Now you know how talented you are. Won't this look marvellous on the bookcase?
Joycey, not there.
Why not? We're not just going to hide it away and forget about it.
Well, if that's the way you feel, Maybe we should put it in the kitchen at Wentworth.
Oh, Murford, what if someone pinches it?
No, they won't. They did try to help me. It'll be good for them to see I appreciate it. And that they've got an award-winning chef cooking for them.
Oh, that's a lovely idea, Mervyn. After all, we will have the microwave at home as a trophy, won't we? Unless you're going to send that to Wentworth as well.
Of course not.
Anyway, congratulations again, Pet. I'm very proud of you.
I still can't believe it. Mm? Now, what are we going to do with the prize money? How would you fancy a new wardrobe?
What?
I thought I'd buy you some nice dresses or a fur coat or something.
No, you spend the money on yourself.
There's nothing I want. Ah, maybe we could go to Fiji or somewhere.
Maybe you could just put the money in the bank until you need it. There is no point in frittering it away.
I'm just going to have to surprise you, aren't I? Oh,
Mervyn, you're very sweet.
Now, what shall I make for dinner tonight? Beef Wellington a la Pringle?
Oh, I think you've done quite enough cooking for one day. No, tonight we are going out for dinner to celebrate. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, that's delicious.
Kate?
I want a word with you.
What about?
Why did you have Flynn tell Mrs. Morris that I attacked you?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you did.
I was with the governor. Now, did someone attack you? Someone you thought was me?
Yeah, well, it must have been.
Where? What happened?
Well, I was on the catwalk, see?
And?
And, there was someone there on the stairs. Behind me, I think. Oh, no! No, you attacked me! You tried to push me over!
That all happened a long time ago, and it was you who attacked me.
Me?
Yes, you very nearly killed me.
Oh, no.
You remember Blackmore?
Yeah.
Well, what happened there?
They sent me to the hospital to make me better.
Why, were you sick?
Well, I must have been.
And how did they make you well?
Doctors. They had good doctors there.
Did they give you ECT?
Oh, I'm not sure. The pills. I remember the pills.
What else do you remember?
Oh, friends. You see, I thought I had these friends at Blackmore.
What about Cynthia? Do you remember Cynthia Leach?
Is she a friend of mine?
Do you remember her?
Look, I don't! Who is she?
Just a friend. Oh, and, thanks, Keen. You've given me all the answers I want.
Kelly, we've come to a decision.
Yeah, whoopee.
I don't give a damn whether you like the idea of the council or not.
Well, I don't. I thought you would have known that by now.
Lexi's clothes were a good chance for her. Could have opened a lot of doors for her when she got out.
Oh, come off it. Who would have paid good dough for that crap?
Exclusive boutiques, that's who.
The fact is that you've done everything you can to blow it for her. Your punishment's 2 weeks' loss of buy-ups. Now get out of here.
2 weeks, you stuck
up. Get out! You're sounding more like Reno every day, Flynn.
She's more than a worry, that one.
Oh, now, what's the matter with you?
Poor Lexi. A chance of a lifetime gone just because of her.
Oh, Willie, we don't know that. Lexi hasn't heard yet.
Okay, we've got one more thing to discuss. Reb Keane.
Are you sure she's not faking?
I'm pretty certain, but what exactly is going on, I'm not quite sure. It's not like she's got amnesia like Willie had.
I wasn't faking. Not the first time.
So you keep telling us.
Reb can remember most of what's happened, except for what she calls her blank spots. Sort of memory gaps in between what she can remember.
She's making the whole thing up.
Maybe she doesn't want to remember.